football helmets out. K-State basketball, we start the second half, Spradling right to the goal, and I count the bucket.
Yep, the defender went through the rim and the net, and that was an easy call. Yep, Doug Simons, James Breeding right on top of it. See, watch, somebody goes right through. Yep, there you go, Miles. Can't go through the rim, obviously, and hit the net, and easy call.
Will Spradling's had himself a good game, 10 points for Spradling.
By the way, we were talking about this at halftime. I don't want to jinx these officials, but they've done a great job in this kind of game tonight because of the way both teams play.
Well, these teams challenge the officials to make decisions every possession multiple times.
Jump hook coming.
Mitchell's been pretty quiet. Soft touch there.
That's great execution right there. Mitchell can shoot the jump hook with either hand. But you know what you love about that? He was uninvolved in the first half offensively. Bob Huggins went into him early. That's good.
Magruder, little runner. Offensive rebound, Gibson.
Oh, I like it. I like the freshman. I love his body. And just like Kulichula, he doesn't need inside to go up and under. Just use that jump hook, attack the offensive boards.
Jones looking for help on the perimeter. And eventually tracked down in the corner. Now a loose ball. Irving comes up with it and gives it off to Spradley. Samuels and Jones banging underneath.
Oh, they got two of them.
Got to be proactive.
Yeah, and I'm not into the double foul, but in that case, it was probably warranted.
Right there, Gary Brown charging the foul.
Now, this is good because I'm just to the officer on the beat. And be smart.
And another one on Brown. So two quickies on West Virginia team besides Jones, Kulichula, and Bryant. And a nice look as they find Samuels.
Great set play, great delivery. Someone set a great screen in there. So they're going to try to get Kulichula some touches. Foul's coming. And John, if you're Bob Huggins right now, you go right at the freshman if you can.
And off that little curl, Truck Bryant gets it to go. 13 for Bryant. He and Jones have been the story offensively. Gibson fouled. He'll shoot two.
Ellis Lincoln, which produced Chris Bosch for Miles, they're familiar with each other. No disrespect to Miles. I bet Gibson was licking his chops when he got the slender Miles down low.
Gibson's gotten himself in better shape. He has played hard for Kansas State. And he picks up an offensive rebound. K-State swinging the ball, and it's a turnover. Ryan pushing. Kulichula. Offensive foul.
Spradling does that really well. He knows where the arc is. He got himself planted. It's a tough play by Bryant. I wouldn't have thrown this ball because you don't want to put Kulichula in a bad spot. You see, those feet were both on the ground before Kulichula left his feet. Will Spradling, you know, Bob Knight said this when he was a freshman. He pointed out how high an IQ basketball IQ he has. Just the little things, John. The screen on the inbound.
And he buries a three. He's got 13. Fran on the defensive end. He had taken 9 charges in the first 4 games.
Yep. He's like your paper boy, you know. He's the guy that was delivering my Dallas Morning News, but he's out here like an assassin.
All of a sudden, it's K-State by 7, and they get a foul on Gibson. They don't have a lot of real good shooters, but he is probably their best. Good look, Kulichula lays it in.
Second time now that they've gotten a basket on that inbound situation. You've got to address that TV timeout. But you're right, John. Spradling does a lot of...
Bryant rips it away from Enriquez. And that'll be goaltending. Enriquez with that one coming down.
Trust Bryant, it's like he was up on Marshallou Parkway right here. Little steal. And now, see, now Spradling really can't get set. He takes it right to the rim. That's good basketball by Bryant. That's either going to be a block.
The truck kind of weaving in and out, doing the serpentine thing.
Now, they're showing zone here, but they did this against Mississippi State, and all they did was match up and play man out of it. So watch the cutters. If you go with the cutter, then you know they're matching up.
Southwell. Magruder almost poked it away. Three-point game. Right underneath, West Virginia basketball. Jones, good work down low.
He was one-on-two, wasn't he? Southwell, Samuels, Jones kept it alive. Jones was anticipating the miss, and that's why you talk about why he's a good rebounder.
Turnover there, Magruder has it. Off the window and good.
Smart. He kind of angled off to the side. Truck Bryant ready to take the charge. He slid right off him.
On their feet here at Intrust Bank Arena, K-State by 5. Now, you mentioned it. You said this is a Kansas State team that at times is going to struggle to score and yet will still win because of defense.
Absolutely. They're going to be dangerous in the Big 12 if they defend.
Kalichla, another one of those jump hooks.
And you know what? You cannot block that shot. He not only gets his body wide, but he shoots it from section 123. That's a weapon.
Spradling now. He finds Southwell. Southwell can handle it, so they get the moving screen there on Adrian Diaz. That'll be our under 16 timeout. Frank Martin's team in the lead. Of course, together at Cincinnati, Bob Huggins helped Frank Martin get his first college coaching job at Northeastern.
Frank was a really successful coach at Miami Senior High School, where he coached guys like Steve Blake, still in the NBA.
Foul on Enriquez, Kalichla.
In the first half, because of the very good Kansas State defense.
Last foul on Enriquez, it's his third.
You know, John, when you talk to the West Virginia coaching staff about Dennis Kalichla, he's a junior, but he's really a sophomore. He missed the first 20 games of his freshman year because of NCAA amateurism rules, playing some professional basketball in Turkey. This guy is just starting to come into his own. 14-7 against a very good Mississippi State team. And he's a sophomore, but unfortunately, he's a junior, but he's really only in his second year of basketball.
I think one of the keys for him this year, this is the first time he's been able to stay behind in West Virginia, working his conditioning, and he's got himself in much better shape. He's played for the Turkish national team in the off seasons the last couple of years, and
that's right.
Really felt like this off season has helped him.
Right, see, they're in that zone, but they're not sure whether they're matching out of it.
Oh, nice roll for Spradling.
Yep. See, they were kind of caught half in zone, half in man. So they screened in for Spradling, and they caused a little confusion.
There's Kalichla again. They're doing a good job getting it to him in deep.
Yeah, absolutely. And that time he did a good job himself of getting deeper with that one dribble into a really nice jump stop.
8 of the 10 points coming since the break for Kalichla. For Magruder, and he still lays it in.
I think if you put Rodney Magruder at power forward, he would still get the job done. You know, because of his toughness, But to have a guard that plays around the rim like that and rebounds like he does is a luxury.
Remember, it's 6'4 and a guard. He led them in rebounding last year.
You got to keep going to him.
Inside against a tough shot.
That's got to count.
And that'll go. Goaltending is Southwell came across.
John, you're not blocking that shot. Now, maybe Anthony Davis of Kentucky's blocking that shot, but he not only uses the width of his body so well, he releases it so far away from his body, it's hard to get to unless you goaltend.
Well, Enriquez is one of the elite shot blockers in college basketball. Huge wingspan. If he's not blocking it...
Well, that's right. Now, with Anthony Davis, you don't take anything for granted with him. I'm not going to go
John
that far.
John Henson found that out.
Yeah, yeah, I'm not going that far. But you're right about Enriquez. It's been some fun.
It's a foul on Jabari Hines, his first team foul, number 7, so it's 1-1. For the junior from Fort Lauderdale, Martavius Irving will go to the line. Been mentioned from Fort Lauderdale, went to the same high school that produced former K-State star Mitch Richmond, Boyd Anderson.
Absolutely, who later went on to Mobley Community College, where he played for Dana Altman. And then to Kansas State, where he played for Ron Kruger, who, by the way, is not only back in the league, but Oklahoma is playing very good basketball. And Ron Kruger, one of the legends of Big 8 basketball, is a former Wildcat player.
A foul on Samuels. That's the two teams put on an officiating crew. Mm-hmm. They really do.
And by the way, the coaches do, too.
That's the truth.
You know? And I'll say this about Bob Huggins, and you know this, John. For a guy that's has been so intense in his career. Soft-spoken away from the court. You know, they were late yesterday, and that Delta Charter was late because he kept his team in class, and they weren't going to leave until about 7 o'clock anyway. And he wound up coming back to bite them, although I don't think there's any ill effect tonight.
Bryant is fouled, and that one on the floor. He went down hard.
Well, it's good. You got to adjust now. If you're guarding the basketball, move your feet a little quicker. These are three Final Four quality guys.
John Higgins, Doug Sermons, James Breeding, our officiating crew. Chuck Bryant's been very assertive in this one.
Well, you know what he does, right? He knows how to use his strength. And that's why he gets to the line 6-7 times a game. He understands that on offense, your body is a weapon. If you can get a defender off balance, you just take it to the defender.
Two-point game.
There's not, even though he can shoot, there's not a lot of, well, there's another one.
This Saturday on ESPN.
It's gonna be fun, going into Assembly Hall. Tom Crean finally has the makings of a quality team. Cody Zeller's been outstanding. Oladipo's improved. Will Sheehy's improved. Jordan Hull shoots it as well as anybody. Can they take care of the basketball versus Kentucky's relentless half-court pressure man-to-man defense, which they never get any credit for?
Looking for help, and they find Irving. Almost backcourt, Rodriguez almost stepped on the midcourt line. Victor Ogilvie, the senior, walking on his check in. Southwell, that floater will go.
Now, they needed that basket. Good move by Southwell, under control, deep in the paint.
Kalichla, they wave it off. Offensive foul. And that is number 4.
You know, it's like stopping an oil tank. It's not going to happen in a mile. You got to give him time to gather himself.
Yeah, he's not going to be able to stop on a dime.
No.
Magruder hanging. And he's charged with an offensive foul. Under 12 timeout.
Harvard's going to play 14 Ivy League games, John. I just can't imagine him not being 13-1 or 12-2. He's potentially undefeated.
Great defense there by Magruder, and a turnover, the five-second call.
Gary Brown, the freshman from Puerto Rico, played at Arlington Country Day in Jacksonville, is getting a lesson tonight because he's going to be a good player. But he's seeing what the effect defense on. He got him again.
A tough night for Gary Brown. Yeah. He's turned it over six times. Tonight, one of those learning situations. Brown with four fouls. And again, when Bob Huggins goes to the bench, he's turning and looking, and it's nothing but freshmen. As Brown goes out, here comes another freshman, Keaton Miles, as Brown with Sid.
And Bob Huggins has now got a way when to bring Dennis Kalichula back in, because he's got four, and the nucleus of this team is the three veterans. So now you're going to play with only two veterans and three newbies.
Starters doing the vast majority of the damage in this one for the Mountaineers. Hines has been quiet, and he puts it in off the glass.
That was nice. Went to his right hand, too, the lefty.
First two of the game for Jabari Hines. He's averaging 11 and a half a game.
Hey, Mr. Basketball, co-Mr. Basketball in New York State, you don't think that's a high honor.
Along with Villanova's Ashraf Yakubu,
who will join the Wildcats next year. John, Martavius Irving, another one of those young players. He does not need to score. He's averaging about 8 points a game, a little under, but his on-ball defense is phenomenal.
I think one of the other things as well, may have gotten,
who has called this game tightly in the second half, and the players have not adjusted, so we're going to be marching to the foul line a lot, and both teams don't shoot free throws well, so rebounding is going to become a premium down the stretch.
Yeah, double bonus the rest of the way. West Virginia as a team 61%, Marine is 67%. And K-State, meanwhile, 65% as a team, as Kalichula watches with four fouls. Gets him back in as Enriquez sits. Gibson inside, and they get the offensive foul. And John Young's going to say, nope, I had a John Higgins, I beg your pardon, saying, no, I had to travel first.
I like it. That's good. That's good teamwork right there. Kevin Jones wants to take a look now. A little pinch post action. I don't know. Contact, I thought, first, but that saves Thomas Gibson a foul. It's still a turnover. I thought the contact was made, and then yes, he was in the air. But what you don't want to do with Thomas Gibson, he doesn't need to put the ball on the floor in tight quarters. He's not that kind of player. Now, if you're Gibson, you don't need to foul Maureen inside.
Kevin Jones been quiet. Hasn't gotten a lot of touches in the second half.
Hey, watch out. Both teams locking down.
Bradley. Rebound. Southwell underneath. Rebound Southwell.
Offensive rebounding. Gives him another chance to score. So even if you don't shoot it at a high rate, the job they do on the offensive glass gives you opportunities.
Three-point game in Wichita under 10 to go in this one.
Man.
Shot clock now at 7. Southwell.
Well, he can't pass to himself. That's right. Good call.
Two and three.
And what they've done is they've kept this crowd relatively quiet. And this is a phenomenal 15,000 attendance crowd tonight. It's a great event. It feels like a tournament game.
Yeah, and Trust Bank Arena is packed. And Packer K-State fans. And again, shot clock winding down. Hines, little pull-up. Good box out there by Southwell as he had Jones on his hip.
You know what he did? He boxed Jones underneath, so he actually boxed in.
Got him too close to the glass, to the rim.
See, if you're going to establish Thomas Gibson inside, you've got to bring the ball below the foul line extended so you get a good angle. Here's a discard, yep.
So they get the foul on.
Put feed from the top. You've got to make sure the defender disappears behind Thomas Gibson.
And I would say Kevin Marine did a decent sell job as well. Got to get your acting chops playing basketball.
Yeah, oh, good crossover.
Jones on the baseline. Oh, that's a tough move in traffic. So it's a one-point game in Wichita. Southwell feed inside. Loose ball. And West Virginia, of course, Bob Huggins coaching is at his alma mater. Coached that 1 year, the 06-07 campaign. K-State went 23-12. Handed it off to his assistant, Frank Martin. He's done great work within the NCAA tournament. Three of the last 4 years.
Now, Bob Huggins brought a winning culture back to Manhattan, Kansas. His greatest contribution. Uh-oh, another rebound.
Miles on the weak side. Lost it for a moment, and then they get the foul on Angel Rodriguez.
Once again, both teams. Now, this is like an inter-squad scrimmage. And it's like the bubbles up on the rim, you know, in the drills. Look at Jones and then look at Miles. That's two guys on the backside, John. I remember mentioning to you a number of times tonight, when you play on offense, I always ran plays. We designed them with the miss in mind. Because if we shot a reasonable percentage, great, but we're going to miss more than 50% of our shots. And West Virginia and Kansas State understand that concept very well.
But what types of things do you do with the miss in mind?
Well, for example, when you run a jump shot play from the right side of the floor, you got to make sure that your best rebounders are attacking the left side at the rim, because 70% of those misses, that's where they're going. If your best rebounders are hanging out the top of the key, that's foolish.
Turnover there. And West Virginia basketball Mountaineers with a chance to take the lead. They have really struggled from the line, and again coming in only 61%, but they're 8-for-17 from the stripe in this one. Hines behind the back, spinning, and it ripped away by Magruder. Here's Rodriguez, lob to Samuels, and one. Keaton Miles, the freshman, he's got four. Mark Samuels, the Washington, D.C. native, not able to complete the three-point play. It's a three-point lead for Kansas State.
You've got Bryant and Jones that are going to do most of the shooting down the stretch, with Colicchio on the bench with four. You got to know that if you're K-State. And you don't want to foul a non-scorer.
Bryant gives off to Jones, who's fouled. Will it be
away from Jones? Take a look. You see, Jones, Samuels is closing out. And a little too much effort right there.
Samuels now with four. And the struggles continue for West Virginia from the line. Kalichla continues to sit. How much longer are you keeping there?
I think it'll be soon. It will be soon. I would say within the next minute or so. I used to like to bring a guy back, depending on the score, with about 5 minutes in a close game, a one or two possession game. Why save him?
But Dennis Calixto has been a big factor in the second half. Samuel sits with the four fouls.
See, the other reason I bring Calixto back soon is because Adrian Diaz, the freshman, is not scoring inside, so he doesn't have to worry about fouling a go-to guy in the lane.
Well, Enriquez, Gibson, and Samuels all with four for K-State.
Good pressure both ways, John. Passing lanes are being guarded like a toll booth, you know, on the FDR drive.
Shot clock at five. Rodriguez the pull-up. Jones the rebound, and now Gary Brown doesn't have numbers. Wisely slows it down.
Did you see his eyes as he was coming up? You know, I was watching his eyes. He's like, I better not do this.
Timeout, Bob Huggins.
Knows Calixto.
He gives off to the freshman, Gary Brown. Brown to the rim, hangs high off the window, and it goes.
Boy, that was opportune for the freshman who struggled tonight. Foul trouble, turnovers.
Lob for Magruder. Bucket won't go. The tip from Diaz, but Magruder will go to the...
Freshmen for Bob Huggins have been mercurial tonight. Watch him hang in the air, draw a little contact. Wow. How about that finish?
The last foul on Keaton Miles, and that is number five, so he is done. Miles, the freshman from Dallas. He has started every game this year so far for Bob Huggins as Aaron Brown, a freshman just outside of Philadelphia, checks back in for the Mountaineers. This is a young, talented team for Bob Huggins, and there is no questioning how hard they play. They compete.
Boy, those are two big misses. That may come back to bite him right there.
It has not been a free throw shooting clinic here tonight. Brown swatted away. Up ahead, Magruder going at Bryant. Lays it in. K-State a 2-point advantage.
That was really Gary Brown's fault because he got in too deep. And the turnover really hurt. Nobody was back.
Jones working down.
Mismatch.
And the foul going up against Southwell.
Yep.
And has his way.
210 versus 260. You figure it out. Jones took his time. He realized he had Southwell. Great patience. And once again, those undersized inside players tonight we've seen make really good efficiency of the jump hook. Take a look. He knows. Backing down. Little jump hook. Money. Guys like Kevin Jones, John, although he can shoot the three some, he's learned how to get his shots off his whole high school and college career over bigger guys, and it becomes an art form.
First lead of the second half for West Virginia. And Kevin Jones basically playing to his season norms here this evening. This Mountaineer team leading by a point, their first lead since they were up 29-28.
Running a little bit of this, they call it the spread off the pinch post.
Magruder soft touch. And 17 for Rodney Magruder.
And unfortunately for Magruder, he was about 6 inches inside the three-point line. Good pressure.
Rodriguez strips it away all alone.
John, early in the game, we talked about Rodriguez and his ability to guard the basketball. He's a lot quicker in terms of the way he moves his feet than he looks.
Robinson, he went down in a heap after that jumper. Spradling to Rodriguez.
I think that was a good acting job in the corner.
Bryant lost the ball, but he's fouled.
This defense thing here with Noreen back.
Frank Martin has brought back Samuels, who's got four, and Gibson, who's got four. But Kalichlis, it's also for K-State, Jordan Enriquez has four.
Now, if you're Frank Martin, you got the four timeouts. So you don't get credit. You can't save them in the bank. So you got to use them if you think you can either run a play or... And here comes Kalichlis back on offense, John. Next dead ball.
Samuels, yep, with the smaller Bryan on him for just a moment. Spradling. Samuels realizing he had Jones in front of him, didn't want to foul.
So now if you're Bob Huggins, you've only got two timeouts left. If you had more than that, it might be great to take a timeout to get Kalichlis back, but Kalichlis is going to stay at the scoring table.
Inside, Jones goes to work against Spradling.
Aaron Brown telegraphed that pass, but Jones did a great job of working his man up the lane. Their grittiness, but they do not have a Jacob Pullen. They don't have a go-to score. Look at this, 1-3-1, right out of the timeout. K-State worked against this yesterday. Now, this is where they have timeout, so if you don't get something, use it, regroup.
Samuels finds Irving, gets into the paint. Samuels hanging.
And that's where the arc is going to be a problem at sometimes, because officials are going to officiate the arc and not necessarily legal guarding position. Oh, good hands.
Spradling diving, trying to knock it away from Brown, who calls time. Oh, their lone senior, their lone scholarship senior. West Virginia up one with the ball, 90 seconds to go. Hines inside. Kalichlis couldn't get it to go.
Kalichlis got hit, and it's 5-on-4 right now. Kalichlis got to get back into play.
Enriquez, offensive rebound, and he's fouled. Big offense.
Enriquez comes up with the rebound.
In there. K-State 11 for 21 from the line. West Virginia's 12 out of 23. And we stay tied at 61, and then a travel. Kalichlis got his feet tied up, got a little tangled up.
Amazing.
Wow. That is huge. And now Gary Brown.
Watch Gibson. He's going to pop.
Rodriguez with Bryant all over him, and they get the foul on that truck Bryant.
Bob Huggins not happy. He wanted a foul at the other end, but Truck Bryant should know better. Why foul Rodriguez? He's really not a threat to score.
Here's the freshman, Rodriguez.
Oh, yeah, he's only shot 6 free throws this season, John.
K-State with the lead.
What is he, 6-for-7 now? I like him. I liked him Sunday night against Virginia Tech. They tell me he has shot the ball better than he has recently. If you add a jump shot to this guy's game, I love his moxie.
In and out, 1-point game, and 1 minute to go in Wichita.
Well, you got Magruder on Jones. That's a good matchup for K-State, but Gibson, I don't think, can guard Kalichlis.
Out of bounds, K-State basketball.
Now they went to the pinch post. They had the ISO on the freshman. Kalichlis just couldn't get it done.
Big turnover there.
Take a look now. Watch. They got the matchup they wanted. There's the drive. Gibson does a really good job of
staying away from Caliccio's body. 1-3-1 now, because if you're Kansas State, you want to use clock. Don't forget, you've got two timeouts left. Got to put someone in the middle of that.
Magruder almost lost the handle.
I'd take a timeout here shortly.
Magruder tosses it up there, gets him a rebound, and puts it back. Huge play, timeout, Kansas.
Up two easily if you attack the rim, and then call timeout, set up your pressure.
Yeah, first good look you get at it. We'll see what they go with. Jones.
Oh, man.
Buries a three.
That's why he's Bob Huggins, and I'm sitting with you. Great set play, great flare screen. Here's the 1-3-1. I don't know if they'll have an answer.
Spradlin being bumped. Clock winding down. Magruder. Tip won't go. We're going to overtime. Kevin Jones hits a monster three to tie it at 64, and K-State doesn't get a good look at the end.
This is why Bob Huggins is closing in on 700. A great flare screen, a great jab step to create some space, and then they throw the one. Hey, look at that. Great jab. He gets Henriquez off him. And then Bob Huggins comes back, John, with the 1-3-1 on the final possession.
10th tie of the night. We're headed to overtime, 64 apiece in Wichita.